Help me with this. This chest is locked and all the sake is trapped inside and suffocating. Oh, we can't let all this fucking alcohol suffocate. If it suffocates, how are we gonna drink it? Don't you know when liquid suffocates, it fucking just evaporates? That's suffocation for you for liquids. Wow, that actually could be suffocation for liquids. Or would it be turning into ice? I think maybe if it turns into ice, it'd be stuff. I'm thinking too much of this. Whatever. Oh, geez. They're drunk. How old are you guys? Different time. That's probably the excuse. I'm sure of it. Oh, geez. They're drunk. Takahiro-kun, can you stop those two? This wasn't the battle I was expecting. Well, expect better things or expect less. Fucking, I don't know. Lower your expectations, kid. Life isn't all it's cracked up to be. I nodded my head in confirmation to Nairumi's request, and I turned towards. Why is it when it's in your head, it's not Nairumi-chan or fucking Sama or some bullshit I don't care about? And I turned towards the two girls on the floor, trying to decide how best to deal with them. With both of them drunk, it would probably have been easy enough to get Mio to release Machiko. I think I said it was differently before. But before I had a chance to intervene, the two girls roughhousing on the floor caused them to bump into the table, knocking over a bottle of sake onto the both of them. Oh, I can't wait for this scene. Oh, I'm all wet now. You spilled the sake. Wow, stupid. The girl pushed herself upright, flailing like a spoiled child before turning tail and running through the door. Good grief. Who knows what she might do. Naru-chan, again, you don't have to- you fucking say the full name in your goddamn head, don't you dare fucking do this shit. Please go get her. In this state, she'd only make stupid advances at me. I was questioning stupid advances, but yeah, right. As the army ran off to retrieve the drunken fox girl, I was left to take care of the remaining few. The two of them. Where's the other one? Mio-san, you need to come with me. We need to get you into something clean. You just want to see me naked. It's the game, but... No, I'm not a pervert. Why does everyone seem to think that? I mean, I do want to see boobs, but I have my honor, damn it. You... I don't like this guy. I don't. Nope. I'm not going to do anything you tell me to. I'll stay right here and swim in sake. Well, swim club's a bit of a ways. I sighed and looked down at the woman who was indeed trying to swim in that tiny puddle of sake on the floor. Taking a deep breath, I prepared myself. Stop drinking, you're underage. Sundir Chief. Enemies have been sighted near the hot springs. Their numbers are about to overwhelm us. I need reinforcements right away. I came with the bluff on the spot, hoping it would get Mio out of the- No, really? I thought you fucking planned that buff out. Fuck it. Yeah, it's a buff now. He used what little mana he had to raise his charm buff. Fuck, wait. To buff his charm. Shit. I fucked up my nerd speak. What? We have to vanquish them at once. Come on, private pervert. To the hot springs. All right, let's go kill the kobolds. But aren't we supposed to defend? Wait, defend what? What are we defending? Whatever, before I had time to finish my sentence, Mio had dragged me to the entrance of the building by collar of my robe. No, attack, attack. Get to the hot springs and attack. I'll be there soon. Wait, why am I going first? And with that, she shoved me through the door with a hefty kick, the door slamming shut behind me. My hearing wasn't perfect, but I could have sworn I heard a yelp and a tumble following Mio's departure. Why did I go here? Why would I? She's fucking intoxicated. Why would I assume that she could get here perfectly fine by herself? With all that shit that was just happening. Why the fuck would... Fuck this main character. A large open area lay ahead of me, closed off by a tall bamboo fence. There was also a small area off to the side for more delicate washing. Sighing to myself, again, which is what I fucking do this entire series, in most series, I began to tidy up the place a little- Well, you're tidying up a fucking hot spring, kid! Shut up! Removing sharp objects and small obstacles that the drunken woman might injure herself on it. Then why would you leave her to get here by herself if this is your main fucking- Oh my god! Fuck it! I hate things. 5 minutes went by before I heard the door open and close, followed by the gentle slosh of someone stepping into the water of the hot spring. The water's great. Hurry up and get in. Whatever happened to attack? I turned around expecting her to be standing in the water with her clothes on. Hey, look at that. Her clothes aren't on, but she's got something covering her. However, the sight that awaited me was far from what I would have expected from Sundir Tyrant. What the fucking names? There was no katana slicing through the air or any harsh words being shouted. Instead, an attractive-looking girl wearing a simple towel had decided to take a seat in the hot water. Kid, you're like, I'm still trying to figure out what the ages around here are. But you still suck. The point of the matter is you suck no matter what is happening. Yeah. It's funny, people probably like I said before, like, why am I questioning the porn game for the porn? But it's a matter of, why wouldn't I question logic bullshit? Like, why wouldn't I? It fucking adds more to it, I think. It might not. No one fucking comments and tells me it doesn't. Fuck it, who cares? I say fuck it a lot too, and who cares a lot too. Again, fuck it, who cares? Whether it was the result of the drinking or not, the warm smile she showed me caused me to pause. Care to join me? I don't think. Ugh, get in the water. Yes, man, you fucking piece of shit. I quickly moved closer to the water, nearly slipping on the wet tiles before I made my way in. I folded up my robe, but kept the towel I had around my waist. Today's been pretty busy, huh? Though, the last thing I expected was for all of you to gulp down sake like a baby drinks its milk. The girl said nothing for a while, regarding me with a faint grin on her face. Regarding me? That might work in some ways, I don't fucking know. It made me nervous. I would almost rather have her shouting and angry. You don't slack off, do you? I can tell that you train a lot. Huh? Yeah, he wants to be the fucking very best in his regional or national tournament, whatever the fuck. Briefly caught off guard by her comment, I quickly gathered my thoughts and nodded in return. Well, I practice judo, which you don't know about, so it's natural for me to train my body a lot. I'm sure the same can be said of you, Mio-san. I mean, you look, rather feminine, but I could tell you knew how to handle a sword. She has a katana for some reason. The other one's got a naginata. Like, I don't really understand these things. Now, that shows diligence and talent, but above all, experience. You started young, didn't you? I did. She leaned back against the rocks and let out a sigh. It took me a long time to become competent with a blade. Days and nights of endless training, regardless of wind and weather. All in order to toughen myself up to make myself strong enough. That was right, though. Like, the Mio thing is here, and when earlier Nairumi thinks her texting wasn't there and made it look like it was fucking narration. It is horrible knowing nothing of your early life. I just turned up here in rags. The guards found me out in the woods one day while on patrol, starving and dirty. Well, I can't wait until the plot twists that you were actually a spirit. The previous village elder took pity on me and took me in. Everything went well for a while. Nairumi's family took me in and treated me like one of their own. Then everything fell apart. Seeing the village that had taken me in, fed me, clothed me, given me shelter, suffering at the hands of spirits, I couldn't take it. As she spoke, she let out another sigh. It seemed the alcohol was making her a bit more talkative than usual, which wasn't a bad thing. I just hoped I wouldn't end up paying for it once she had sobered up. You will. After that, I felt like I had to do something. I couldn't just sit by while everything fell apart around me. The village was devastated by the fires. On that day, I pleaded with the former chief of the guard to train me, make me stronger. I wanted to protect the village, to protect Nairumi at any cost. He eventually agreed, but told me that I would need to strengthen my resolve first. So make sure you're fighting for the right thing, or else you won't fight. Do it. That's why you became a, you can say it, a Sundir Tyrant. Now, why didn't you fucking use a different word entirely? Like, I don't understand that. Why did you have to use Sundir Tyrant? Maybe to please the audience, the Sakura Spirit audience. Or this was like their first game, wasn't it? Or their first visual novel of the Sakura series, I believe. I don't know what tsundere means, but the tyrant part isn't far off. That's another thing. Why the fuck use that word? Whatever. It's one of the, if I said, like, it was one of the first games or whatever the fuck it is, first localization, whatever you want to call it. Either way, you know, mistakes were made. Clearly, as that's not the case in the other variants of the games. But still, goddamn. But the tyrant part isn't far off. I didn't want to drive everyone away, least of all Nairomi. But I had to, in order not to feel the pain of loss again. Spirits haven't been our only problem. Bandits, beasts, and the weather. Yes, so that way I won't feel the pain of losing everyone. I strengthen my resolve by saying I will protect everyone so I don't lose everyone. What? You're gonna fucking mostly disconnect yourself from everyone so that way you can be better at caring about people? What?